10,000 subscribers. Uau! Jakuyam Valmi Pekni. Thank you so much to all of you who watch, like, shared, and supported me in this journey. Also, big thanks to all my channel members who went an extra mile to support me in my journey here in Slovakia through YouTube. I hope you guys are enjoying my exclusive content for you, and just so you know, I made a playlist for you guys so that you can watch anytime all my videos that I created for you. Tell me if you like it. So to celebrate this little milestone in our YouTube channel, I decided to get a little bit more personal with you guys. So I'll be answering some of your questions, actually all the questions that you asked me or anything about me at all in this video. I posted in all of my social media accounts, so I got tons of questions from you guys, and really thank you so much for your big interest about me and my life here in Slovakia. So without further ado, let's go to the questions. Let's take the questions from my Facebook account first, and this is from my friend Lawrence Canwell, a good friend of mine from the Philippines, and she is asking, what is my motto in life? The mantra that I always stick to, whatever is happening in my life, is this too shall pass. I love this because it reminds me to not to hold on to things, because nothing is permanent in this world and everything changes. So whatever circumstances we have in this life, whether bad or good, just remember that all of this will pass. And it's good, you know, because during bad times, you can calm down, because knowing that this bad time is not gonna last forever, so you can move on with your life. And during good times, you cherish more these good times, because you know that it's not gonna last forever as well. So, isn't it beautiful? So now it's your turn. What is your motto or mantra in your life right now? Leave me in a comment below. I would love to know. Now, on to the next questions are questions from my Instagrams. And if you haven't followed me in Instagram yet, follow me. I share some of the stuff about my everyday life here in Slovakia there. So check it out. So my first question from Instagram is from Nikotinka. I hope I pronounced that right. I would like to know if it's okay for you to tell, how old are you? You look really young, sometimes 15 years old, I would say 15 years old in your videos. And also second question is, what is the worst and best characteristic of Slovak people for you? Very difficult question. I am not 15 years old, definitely. I'm not a teenager anymore. I wish I am. But it's funny because I get this question a lot, because really, I look young, but I love to look young and I love to be young. We know that our body will not be young forever, but we can keep the enthusiasm of a kid, and that makes our life more enjoyable, I'd say. So, who can guess my age? It will be fun. Leave me in the comments below what you think is my age now. To your second question, I like the fact that Slovaks hold on to their identity very much. They know what they want and what they don't want. And also, I like the fact that young generations are still valuing the Slovak traditions. That's nice. On the contrary, I wish that Slovaks will have more positive outlook in their life or in everyday whatever, and would smile more, because smile brings you a lot of positive energy and you don't lose anything. Just smile. This is just a pure observation on my part, and maybe my opinion will not be the same as the others, so I understand and respect it. Next question is from Dada. Have you ever dyed your hair? Nikdy. I did once straighten my hair when I had it during my college years, because back then having a really long hair and straight long hair was really cool. So I had it done, but then I regretted it later on because the treatment just ruined my hair. So after then, I stopped using chemicals in my hair already. So next question is from Matej Belko. Have you ever seen a Slovak film? I did. I have seen this movie called Pelishki movie, but I'm not sure if it's Slovak. I think it's Czech, or it's not. I don't know, I'm not sure. So second question is from Odores del Sole. I hope that I pronounced that right. Her question is, hey, so I'm trying to learn Slovak myself too. Good. And I share your same struggles. Do you have any suggestions about books or materials I could use to practice and improve? Ďakujem, your contents are great. Oh, thank you. And I love that you're learning Slovak. So good. So in the beginning, I was using Krizom Krazom. And then later, I also enrolled myself in a free online Slovak course. I will leave the link of the websites in the description below so you can check it out later. But most importantly, my best advice to you is practice the language. If you learn small phrases, use it, talk to Slovak, and really practice them. That is the best way that works for me, and I hope that it will also work for you. So, congratulations for having the courage to learn the Slovak language, and I'm rooting for you. So, next question is from Svetlankine Dobroti. Why did you choose just Slovakia? Well, I really did not choose Slovakia. It just so happened that I am married with a Slovak guy and we decided to move here after things didn't work out for us in the Philippines. Next question is from Leila 42. What is 42 in Slovak? Štyri sa dva. Okay, the question is, I have so many questions. Is it hard to find a job in Slovakia for somebody who is not speaking Slovak? Did you find something weird in our society that is totally normal for us? And your top three favorite Slovak food. Can you introduce yourself in your native language? Looking forward to watch your videos. Oh, thank you. And you have a lot of questions. I would say that I really didn't have a hard time finding job here in Slovakia back then. I actually made a video about that, so you can check it out later. And on your next question about a weird thing in Slovakia, to be honest, I didn't find anything weird about Slovakia. I guess I'm weird as well, so maybe that's the reason why. And my top three favorite Slovak food would be, of course, brinzové halušky, istrapačky, and lečo with rice. Yummy! And to your last question, or maybe not a question, but a request to speak in my native language. So my native language is Tagalog or Filipino, so I'll try my best. Kamusta? Ako nga pala si Kim, isa akong Pilipina na naninirahan dito sa Slovakia. Samahan niyo po akong diskubrihin ang napakagandang bansang ito, Slovakia. Yan! Ganyan mag-introduce sa Tagalog. Okay, next question is from Calisthenics Nomad. I am a Slovak guy living in Thailand. Wow! And I love watching your videos. Oh, thank you! I've had the chance to see a lot of Southeast Asia, but sadly haven't made it to the Philippines yet. You should, but hopefully someday, yeah. I will visit your homeland too. Okay, so my question is, beside your family and friends, what is the one thing that you really miss about Philippines? Oh, this is an easy question. One thing that I really miss about Philippines is the sea. It's because I love swimming, I love diving, and I can really imagine my life having just a small hut, living my life near the sea and just swimming all day. It's so beautiful life, and I'll be happy too. If you've seen my video about why I moved here in Slovakia, then you would know how much I love the sea. The next question is from Mianka Vargova. How, where, when did you meet your husband? Will you show him to us? I wish you a lot of patience with the Slovak language. Oh, thank you. Sometimes it's difficult even for native Slovaks. Okay, thank you so much for that question, Janka. My husband and I met when he was traveling for the first time in the Philippines. He was working and studying in Sydney, Australia for like 5 years. And then one time he decided to visit Philippines, and that's how we met. And after that, he keep on coming back to the Philippines. And you can see him already in two of my videos. He already appeared to some of my videos already, so you can check them out. Now to the next questions coming from my YouTube channel, and I got a lot of questions from you guys. And the first question is from Andrea Simanco. You want to stay here in Slovakia and have a family, or once you will return to the Philippines? I don't think so. I will probably stay in Slovakia and have family here. So it's gonna be like that. Next is from Progress Official. Is there something you want to try here in Slovakia, an experience, and you had not chance or opportunity to do so yet? Yes, I have a lot of things and stuff that I want to do when all this craziness finish. First, I want to see Tatras Mountain, because I've also been hiking in the Philippines back then, but I expect that Tatras will be like so much different level, so I want to be prepared for that. But definitely I am excited to see Tatras. Next question is from Alpha. What are the major differences in people's mentality between Slovakia and the Philippines? Very interesting question. I have noticed some, and I want to make a video about it where I compare Slovakia and Philippines in different aspects. But just to answer your question, I will give you one of the most important observation that I have about these two countries, and it's related to the family values. In the Philippines, it's very common, but not all, of course, especially in the poor family, to put the burden of having or bringing a brighter future for the family to the children. At a very young age, we were taught to dream about having a good job, be successful, so that we can provide a better life for our parents and our family. There is a good and a bad side on this story, and I would love to elaborate about this more in my next videos. On the other hand, I notice here in Slovakia that kids are taught to be more independent. At a certain age, they kind of break away from their parents and try to find their place in this world with the support of their parents, and I really like that. In the Philippines, if you let your parents living alone while they are already in their old age, it is frowned upon by the society. You will be easily judged as a bad or selfish daughter or son. But here, I'm really surprised to see Babichka and Jedko living alone even at the age of 80, or if they cannot take care of themselves anymore, they go to the nursing house. For us Filipino, it is really not the way how we do it. Normally, there is one kid who takes the responsibility of taking care of the parents when they get old. There will be more about this comparison between Slovakia and the Philippines in my future videos, and I'm working on it. And I hope that the two countries will benefit from each other, learning from each other. I hope so. Next question is from Katarina Ondrejcakova. Hoki, I enjoy your content. Oh, thank you. I would be interested to hear more about your country and brief history, as well as your native cuisine. Thank you. Philippines is amazingly beautiful country in its own right, and the people there are so happy even they have a hard life, and I really admire them for that. We also have a fair share of a beautiful history, not really beautiful, but brutal history as well, just like Slovakia. We were colonized by Spaniards for like 333 years, and then there is America, then came Japan, so we also have a lot of colonizer. Is that even a word? As for the food, you would already know that most of our food are influenced by the countries that colonized us. So we have a lot of food that are influenced by Spaniards, and we have hot dogs and spams from from America. We love hot dogs and spams. They love hot dogs and spams. I don't. And we also have a lot of Asian cuisine that are inspired by Japanese, maybe Korean. Now it's really famous in the Philippine Korean food. But in terms of traditional or most famous dish, Filipino dish, I would say that adobo is like the most famous. This is basically like a meat, which is normally chicken, and it's cooked with soy sauce and vinegar and garlic and onion, and we eat it with rice. So yummy. Okay, next question is from Kombashan Pratska. Do you and your partner feel kind of restricted when talking to each other in English? like kind of basic, not as complex conversation as they would be in your mother languages. For example, I like to play with words when making some little jokes, swapping the letters, mixing the meanings, and that would be difficult without having extensive vocabulary in phraseology. We both have different native language and English is what connects us. I find it really amazing, really, how can it be possible? But of course, we are not perfect in English. We also make mistakes, and sometimes it gets frustrating when we are having our argument and we cannot totally express ourselves. But the good thing is sometimes whenever we make mistakes in English, we can make fun of each other. So it's a plus to build our relationship. I don't think that language should be a barrier to any kind of relationship. If we are willing to learn, listen, and understand each other, then there shouldn't be a problem anymore. I feel like I joined Miss Universe with all these questions because you guys gave me a lot of hard questions. So let's go to the next. It's from Maricek. He says, Unas Snezhiriadni. I don't think that this is a question, but I would say dobre. Next is from Chris B. How did you meet your husband? I answered this already. I met my husband when he traveled to the Philippines and we crossed path there. Next is, are you planning to study for something while you are in Slovakia? What is the point of view? What is your point of view for foreigners who want to move to Slovakia? How long does it take to get permanent resident in Slovakia? Thank you. Yes, I do. I am planning to take a language Slovak course in the future. Now, to your next question, I feel like as a foreigner myself, I'm not in the best position to answer this question for the Slovaks. So I will try to answer this as a Filipino if the foreigner will move to the Philippines. As long as they come to the country legally and they work and contribute to the betterment of the whole economy and don't make a mess and follow the rules and regulations of the country, I have no problem with that. We don't own anything in this world, but we have to respect the locals that have been living in this country for so long. And on your third question, in Slovakia, I believe you can apply for permanent visa or permanent resident visa for 5 years. And if you serve it, then you can apply for citizenship after 5 years. And if you don't want to be a citizen, then you can just apply for a permanent visa without expiration. Next question is from Alzbeth Pets. Do you want to learn grammatic stuff in Slovak language or is passive Slovak enough for you? Well, I will try to learn the basic stuff. My aim is not to be in scholar level where I will master the language. I just want to be able to communicate with people. That's it. Also, maybe if I am capable, I'll be able to speak fluent in Slovak, and then I want to go shopping in an open door market, let's say, and I'll try to approach some babichka selling some vegetables and try to speak in English, and she will not speak to me, and all of a sudden I speak fluent Slovak and she will be shocked. I will be interested to know what will be the reactions of the people when they finally see me speak fluent Slovak. Next question is from Sam Kul. Do you want to stay in Bratislava? I do, but who knows what the future brings? Can change. What will happen in the future? We don't know. Next question is from G4NY Medes. Oh, this is my star. Hello. So, question is, do you like winter and snow, ice? I really don't like winter. It's not my favorite just because I don't like cold coming from a warm country like Philippines. But I love snow. I am very happy recently because this winter it brings a lot of snow days here in Bratislava, and I was able to make 2 snowmen. If you've seen my video, you've seen one of my snowmen, and I really, really love that. Next question is from Branislav Romantak. Do you play on any instrument or sing? I wish I do, but unfortunately I don't have this talent. If you've seen my recent video about making horalki by my own, then you have seen how I sing. And that is the best I can do. Okay, next from Elmond. Philippines gem is C. Yes, totally agree. What about Slovakia gem? Slovakia's mountain. When do you want to visit them? Not just Visoké, Nízké, Tatry, but also Velká, Malá Fatra, Slovenský kraj, Pieniny, Poloniny.
Slovenský raj, no?
Ah, Slovenský raj. Yeah, right. Pieniny, Poloniny. I don't even know where this place is. All I can recognize is Malá Fatra and the Tatra Mountains. But definitely agree that Slovakia's gem would be its mountains. It's so beautiful. And I have said I am already looking forward that when all this pandemic thing finishes, then we can already travel safely. I will definitely hike the Tatra Mountains, but I need to prepare for it. Because back then in the Philippines, I have said I was also trekking mountains, but I expect that this is going to be like a different level. So I need to prepare for it. But I've said I'm totally, totally excited to see the Tatras. Next question is from mysteries.sk. What place would you visit first after the virus ends? I really like to see the Slovakia paradise. I hope this all pandemic things ends soon so we can travel and I'll be able to see a lot more of Slovakia. Next question is from Blort Eska. How is it to be from Philippines and living in Slovakia? It wasn't so bad. To be honest, I have more good memories than bad ones. But I think I would say that the thing that I had to adapt more is the weather here in Slovakia, because coming from a warm country, Philippines, and I came here during the start of the winter. So you can imagine that I had to adjust a lot, and it was really super cold for me, so I didn't go out much. And with the clothing, I really don't like wearing a lot of layers during the winter because you have to prepare yourself and it takes time, and then when you come home you have to take it off and it takes time again. But when I was in the Philippines, I was just wearing t-shirt and shorts and flippers and I can just go on every day, all day, every day. So it's like that here. Next question is from Pierre Vermeiren. Congratulations and wish you many more viewers. I watched to see another foreigner's view on Slovakia and your content is fun and well presented. Not a question, but thank you so much for your appreciation. I really, really like to hear from people that they like my content. Next is from Emma H. Why did you move to Slovakia? P.S. Your channel is awesome and really fun to watch. Thank you, Emma. And as I have said, I moved here because my husband is a Slovak. Next question is from FIFO Vrabel. Hey Kim, just wanna ask why you pick Slovakia as your main country? Like, there is so much better options than Slovakia. Don't get me wrong, it's beautiful country, but not really worth it for citizens, I think. Anyways, I really love how you promoting our country. It's special. Think which should be definitely more popular here. Lots of Slovaks ain't realizing how beautiful country we have. They all just see the bad things. Thanks for answer. Have a great day, buddy. Technically, I did not choose Slovakia as the main country where I want to live because my husband is Slovak, so we decided to live here instead. But if you've watched some of my videos, then you would know how much I adore Slovakia. And I think that not a lot of people here from Slovakia appreciate what they have in their country. Next is from Marek Blahovets. Can you say hello to me, please? I mean in the video. Hello, Marek. Next, Lenka Vnokova. What you like most about Slovakia? I like living in Bratislava, the capital city, just because the city is so clean. There are a lot of parks everywhere and I can just easily walk, have a fresh air, and you can hear singing of the birds, and these things you can never really have in the capital city of the Philippines, Manila. So I really appreciate that. Next is from Mikal Patrikar. Wow. Yes, wow. Ahoy, Mikal. Next is from My Playlist For You. You have your favorite aesthetic. I'm not sure what you mean about the aesthetic or about what is this question is about. So leave me a comment below. Maybe I can answer. Next is from Martina M. What's your mother tongue? My mother tongue is Tagalog or Filipino because I am from Philippines. And next is from Nita Patel. Wow, great. Thanks, Nita. Next is from Martinko Corfanta. Please try to speak Slovak language for 24 hours. This will be difficult, but maybe I can make a video of it. It will be like a challenge. What can I do in 24 hours of speaking Slovak? What do you guys think? Let me know. Next is from 9991 Bobo. Will you create any video about Filipino or about Philippine? I definitely will, and I am already working on some videos where I will speak about Philippines and Slovakia. So watch out for that. Next is from Kotegawa XCIX. Do you plan to get the Slovak citizenship one day? This is something that is something that I'm still thinking over, because Slovakia doesn't offer dual citizenship, and I also don't want to lose my Philippine passport and Philippine citizenship, so I'm still not decided yet. Next is from Free Lark, just mushrooms. Maybe Free Lark wants to go for mushroom picking as well. Next is from Vikushka. Ayak Tem East. Ano Aya. Hoyo. Next is from Hoyo YT. Pekni Ahoy. Ahoy yo. Hoyo. Ahoy hoyo. Next is from Stella Vida Nova. Kutoru Farbu Mash Nairad She. Moya Oblubena Farba Fialova. Next. From Bianca Palatskova. What do you do for a living? Was it hard for you to find a job here if you don't speak Slovak? Well, I work as an analyst, and back then I did not have a hard time finding a job, but I could imagine now that it would be hard because of the pandemic thing. So I guess that's it. That's the last question for me. All right, that's it, guys. I did not think that I will receive a lot of questions from you guys. So many questions that are very interesting and challenging. So thank you so much for participating in this video. And special thanks also to my channel members for supporting my journey here in Slovakia. I appreciate you so much, guys. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and hit the bell for more videos in the future. And if you want to be my member as well, just click on the join button and you will be my star. Now tak, dobre, ciao, share!